I'm in the basement rooms underneath Diocletian's palace, and I have to say it's really quite fragrant in here, which is a great advert for a certain brand of bleach, because just 50 years ago, people had to come in here wearing protective equipment because all sorts of had been dumped down here. An awful lot of poo from up there had been collecting in this space. You'd have to sort of wade through it, climb through it, whatever. There was all manner of rubbish, and it must have been quite rank. But I can say that they cleaned it up extremely well. And I'm not suffering. I don't need any specialist breathing equipment. I'm fine. And you can see, particularly on the lower walls, how everything's been scoured. I imagine they had to get the brushes out and give it a really good, thorough going over.
There's a bit of seepage there. Ew.
There's a public bit where they'll just try to sell you lots of expensive tourist tat, but if you pay a bit extra, you get to see far more of the basement. And, well, yes, it does lack atmosphere a bit, all electrically lit and bereft of its furnishings. But here's a detail I like. You see, a You Are Here map. All dungeons should have those. But let's test the effect of moody music.
What are you laughing at? I meant to do that.
The seventh time you've done that.
No, it isn't. Oh, what do we have here? An olive press?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, we have an olive press.
For those of you unfamiliar with ancient olive presses, a winch pulled a rope which then pulled down a lever which exerted massive pressure on a big bag full of olives which then disgorged their oil into a trough. Easy enough. Here you can see some of the stone uprights that contained the winching mechanism. And you can see the bit there which went under the big bag with the spout and the trough.
There are lots of tantalising glimpses into spaces beyond. We can't get into that bit there. I'm not going to throw anything through to see what happens. But there's always this knowledge that there's more than we're seeing. Ah, I found the rubble store. This is where they stored their rubble. How well built this all is. This was built to last. Look at this. Look at this stone here. Look at the work that went into getting that to fit. And that's a really big stone. And we're down in the basement here. No one posh is going to see this. But the need they felt for the structural integrity was such that they built it this well. The top stones, where the roof is corbelled, they're rougher and more mundane. But down here, the fundamental basics, my hat off to them.
Lindybeige!